I cannot believe the last video did as well as it did. It's at 60,000 views right now, and it's a trip to the thrift. And if you guys have been following me for years, you guys know, before I ever even discussed Supreme on this channel, I was making videos showing you guys what you can find in the thrift store. And I'm extremely grateful that I'm actually at a point where these thrift videos are doing so well. To every single person who smashes the like button, shows love in the comments, shares the video with other individuals, I sincerely appreciate you. I was complaining about Supreme videos for a long time, and it's not because I don't like Supreme. I still enjoy Supreme. But for me, creating that content became kind of stale, especially when it came to the editing. To basically fix that situation, I have considered making a separate channel where I live stream my reaction to the drop list. I still will discuss the drops within Plus One, which if you guys don't know, that is my cook group. In that group, we obviously give you guys tools and information to help you get into reselling Supreme, Palace, tons of other streetwear brands, sneakers, game consoles, graphics cards, a plethora of different things. I'm not gonna talk about the group too much in this video. If you guys want to see all the features of Plus One, of course, check out the description down below. And a lot of people have been asking me about information when it comes to thrifting. I've been considering creating some guides and posting those in Plus One. I want Plus One to be a hub of information for people who want to get into reselling. And I know no other group owner actually knows vintage. I will say this week, I don't think these things will do anything crazy. I'm still going to cop a pair. These Shrek items, I think the beanies will do fairly well, especially if you look at the Cat in the Hat beanies. There's some margins to be made. And I think the Shrek skateboards will be decent hold items over time. I don't really have much faith in anything else, but there's still money to be made. You already know, you're never too good to make a little bit of extra cash on the side. But that being said, we're gonna get straight into the video. Hopefully you guys showed some love. I have to drive all the way up north, but first I gotta make a quick little stop and pick up a package at the post office.
Thank you. Ain't no stress, no bitches, no love. Bitch, I'm from the city, why you gotta keep a gun? Why you gotta call life, no heart, go gun. If you run up on me, you gon' die on me. No stress, no bitches, no love. Bitch, I'm from the city, why you gotta keep a gun?
First stop, we got some special guests in the building. We got the Sneak City fan. We got my boy Nate right here. He's gonna show us around a little bit today up north. But yeah, let's see what we find.
These guys are doing a challenge, first to 150.
You're at what, 25?
I'm at 25. I'm at 35.
And like 165.
Made in the USA. Camera bag. They usually go for about $100.
Next location.
All right, we are here at spot number two. St. Vincent
de Paul. Hanes Beefy. This is a good tag to look out for in the thrift. It's a 90s tag. Because it's a little basic, I would honestly sell it for around that price on Thrift Row. Make sure you check out the website. You know we always got deals. A piece like this I pick up in the bins. We've got this International Boeing long sleeves, Hard Rock tee, probably early 2000s. Look at the flowing lava creating a guitar. That is absolutely fire. Chest hit right there, little.
That's
little.
Hey!
What's the totals right now?
70. I'm at like 40.
That jacket's hard. Little Patagonia joint right when we walked in.
There you go, sweetie.
Thank you so much. The other day at the racks wasn't the best, but you already know we're at my favorite spot. We came here yesterday, I found some bangers. Hopefully we find some heat today. First row, a lot of blankets, but found a super nice essential Carhartt. I love these old military tees, Operation Desert Storm. So Yaz was going through the old bin, and I'm not gonna lie, sometimes I sleep on these bins, but look what she found. Ooh, the velour, yeah. Stussy tag, size small. This is super soft, Stussy hit right on the chesticle.
Yeah.
Shut it. Hurry up.
Run, go.
Your clothes don't fit.
Leave me alone.
Goodwill bins, day two. Technically day three. Day one wasn't filmed. I'm giving you guys too much information. Ooh, don't unfold everything.
I'm honestly notorious for doing that.
Some absolute bangers. Yasmin found this. Calvin and Hobbs. Hobbs has some holes on the Onita. Distressing around the neck, size medium. If this fits, I will be keeping it. Little homie right here. Thank you, appreciate you. Okay, just keep walking. Anyways, he found me cards right here. Some Magic the Gathering cards, and was absolutely crazy about this find is the fact that I'm wearing a Magic the Gathering shirt. I'm about to start playing Magic the Gathering again, man. This is a song. Other than that, we got this 2001 Betty Boop, and we have Baby Milo. Sadly, there's no zipper, which is a flagrant offense because this North Face over here also has no zipper. Really good day. Especially this Calvin Hobbs shirt.
Who found that? That's crazy.
You found it.
I know.
I got this. I kind of want to use this for something. I'm getting some expertise from the man who shall not be named. Do you know what year this is from?
Probably late 70s, early 80s.
Just sold this for $25. Basically pays for the day. Day two was pretty successful. All right, third day at the bins. Fun fact, she loves unfolding everything I just get done folding. Two rotations down, got some Carhartts, Nike hoodie, Nike crew neck.
What about you?
That's gonna look good on you though. Can you try that on for the viewers?
It's gonna look good on him, especially with this crop top that he found.
Okay. Oh man. Ooh, a DIY joint. USA made navy sweats. Shout Jerry Lorenzo. And look at this. Just in time for Halloween. It's getting spooky. Yo, the Carhartt detail. Look at the Carhartt buttons with the hearts. Oh, it's got shit stains. Oh, man. This little girl shit herself.
Have a good day.
You as well. Not bad for only an hour.
All right.
We decided to go on a little hike, some good views.
And to start these videos, I've been trying to show you that I go to the thrift store on a regular basis, multiple days. Some people see the thrift hauls, they see everything that I get, and they think that just the thrift stores locally are some great, amazing thrift store. You gotta make sure to put in the time, go consistently. We actually thrifted with some special guests.
Yeah!
Did I say we thrifted with special guests? Well, I guess in this video they did, but that was like 5 days ago now.
On time.
That's me with the camera out. Oh, we already hit one rotation.
Shut the fuck up.
Why are you wearing a shirt with two fighters and you don't fight?
I trained just to get my ass whipped.
I hope they stole your 49ers jacket. Anyway, it's time to hit some more rotations.
As per usual, anytime I come to a Ben's location, I like to sleep on the ground.
Did it. This is Oakland, California. Dumpsters right there. Football and needle right there.
The man has blessed us.
All right, from the last rotation, I found this. And then, of course, Andres has to on me real quick.
Damn, good size.
Ooh, the Andazia.
Ant went back to hit where he found those Nike pieces, found another Nike windbreaker. RJ found this dope classic card.
Ron looks like he is a player.
Loki has some chicken legs. RJ found this super dope contrasting collar, and it has the Siemens breast hit.
Grow up.
So this is actually not gonna be for sale. My homie RJ found it and then passed it to me, and then he wanted it for the personal, so I'm gonna pass it to him. My boy Julian, much love. All right, my bro RJ is finally editing a video. Right, so I gave the homie this shirt and then ended up buying some stuff off me for $20. And then I ended up buying this off him for $20.
Appreciate you.
We're just saying that now. They shut the doors.
No!
We just waited an hour for another rotation. Sadly, there was nothing.
Okay, so I think it's like day four at this location. Always hit or miss. Hopefully today is not one of those days.
Today is definitely not one of those days. First up,
this is a good essential blank. Sadly, it looks like someone was shot with some shotgun spray. I don't know if the individual wearing this was starring in The Matrix, but he was clearly not doing his job dodging any bullets. Got a little vintage France tank top. Hooters Pit Crew, Daytona Beach. But what's really dope about this, look at that back hit. Ooh.
This doesn't exist anymore.
Damn, way to hit us with a geological fact. Little starters, essential crew neck, champion reverse weave. This embroidery is looking absolutely scrumptious. And the all-time best find of the day, this gorgeous badass reindeer on the back. Millions of beautiful, tiny, shiny little threads going through and piercing the back of this Carhartt. Look at this.
Look at that, that's nice and shiny.
Carhartt patch right down there by the lower abdominal or cock region. Ooh, you see it.
I told you.
I and the S, basically in my head, started playing Hangman on the US made Russell Athletic. These are some of the best fitting hoodies and crew necks. We got some holiday sweaters with the embroidered nut bags, snowflakes dripping. You know any holiday songs?
Jingle bells.
Little USA Olympics embroidered on the titty. She found this in an old Benz once again. Not a bad day. Free money. You're never too good to pick up free money. What you have in life, it can all be gone tomorrow.
Find anything good?
That's fire. I have yet to have a decent meal today. I'm gonna go to this blazing bagel spot. Hopefully I can go get the bagel and make it back before they do another rotation.
Ooh, I didn't even notice this. Best bagels east of New York.
It's a pretty bold claim, buddy. The French toast breakfast sandwich, sweet and savory. The trip to Seattle was worth it just for this delicious, tasty, delectable little treat. Come on, please say green light so I can go. No Squid Games. I haven't gotten a text, so I'm assuming I made it there and back.
I got one t-shirt, that's it.
On the way back, I'm gonna try to hit some racks. I've been waiting for 20 minutes because RJ likes to drive in the slow lane.
Got stuff behind a desk.
This is why knowing tags is crucial.
You can spot a vintage tag from a mile away, but I do not like that price tag. What is it? This one would be super cool on the Onita too. Oh, it's got this 1.6 on the back. Now these two I think are pretty dope. Especially this one, Air Washington. On the good made in the USA Fruit of the Loom, Onita. These ones are found by Ant.
What are these?
The Boys.
Oh shit. What's real crazy about this Value Village is this used to be where I would go and I'd always find Banties. I will say though, Tia's dad, the homie Nate, he always finds heat in these racks.
What would you sell something like this for?
It's like they're selling on eBay for like $17 to $18.
Hey! Value Village in Tacoma? You're not feeling it?
Main Street Thrift is closed.
This one's not bad though.
Air Washington, it's like a ski tee.
Probably could call it a day, bro.
Damn, this line is long as fuck. Okay, my homie right here goes to UW. I went to UW, graduated. Tell me this does not look like an NFT. I also bought this. It may be our rivals, but you got a little pussy cat right there. Single Stitch Mariners. I found these Orange Tab Levi's in the bin. Acid Wash. You're just gonna steal my hat?
Yeah.
I got a big head, huh?
I know.
Bro was complimenting the hat. Look at the chain stitch.
Yeah, this
color
I had to find.
The last legal high. Raven's Brew Coffee. Honey Onita Single Stitch. Little Blue Bar Gildan tag. Early 2000s. Not a bad stack, but I forgot my wallet. Thankfully, the homie at the bins got me covered, but I had to stop on my unit so that way I could grab some Halloween tees to post to the site. Halloween is quickly approaching. We got the Happy Halloween Single Stitch on the freeze tag. You guys saw me find this booty once again, Single Stitch on the Hanes Heavyweight with the nut encrusted boost spell out and the Walking Dead AMC promo tee, actual screen print. Single Stitch Mariners. We got some Huskies crew necks. This right here is probably one of my all-time favorite Hooters tees. Hooters branding on the hood of the car. Another little Hooters tee that I grabbed from the unit just to post with that. So many good finds. Even this right here, you might think this is a regular Jack Daniel's shirt. Pete the back with this beautiful, meaningful quote. So many dope Single Stitch tees coming to the site. Riff Row, check it out if you have not already for whatever reason. Some other bangers. This one right here, I'm not quite sure whether it's real. I know it says made in Japan. If this was not just a little bit too baggy, I would just keep it for myself. And both of these should be posted to the site as we speak. The beautiful burgundy Western Carhartt. You see that little drop down? These little vampire teeth on the titties with the corduroy collar. Another piece that I wish fit. White tag, tonal Nike check. I still have to photograph some of these. I've been really busy trying to move everything into my unit. I'm gonna show you guys some of the stuff from this drop, but I'm also gonna show you guys some of the stuff from upcoming drops. The majority of the items I showcase, including all the items I just showed you guys, will be available on ThriftRO. That's ThriftRO. Make sure you follow the Instagram, and of course, the Instagram and website will be in the description down below, along with a link to my own personal Instagram, the Starlife, ThestarrLife. Now, in the beginning of this video, I went to the post office to pick up a package from my dear friend Trap. He is a staff or admin in Plus One, and he actually sent me this vintage Why can't I grab this? It's a Single Stitch, originally on a Changes, has draped up and dripped out in the Seattle Sonics gear. Seattle Sonics is no longer a team, but if you look, he's wearing number 40. Shout out Sean Kemp. Now, another one that may or may not be a personal, it fits pretty similar. However, I don't know if I can keep this, is this Wazoo shirt. I actually bought this off of another picker. This piece is a banger. I wanna keep it because it is a Washington school. However, that being said, I actually went to UW. And one of my favorite tees that I got from this video is this Calvin and Hobbes tee. I love the way this fits. I like these tighter fitting tees, kind of fits more like a 70s or 80s tee. You guys don't know what Calvin and Hobbes is. Maybe you guys are not like myself. I used to read this in elementary school. You may have some slight recollection of this little troublemaker right here because you may have seen him pissing on some illicit goods. For example, if you see a Ford truck, he may be pissing on a Chevrolet logo. And if you see a Chevy truck, he may be pissing on a Ford logo. He just loves to urinate on a plethora of different consumer brands. Since I added some personals, I got rid of a personal. I'm gonna be posting this to the site. Some tees that may not be posted right now, but if you guys wanna stay up to date, of course, follow the Instagram, turn on post notifications. This Stussy tee is also gonna leave the personal collection. You guys have seen me wear that. This other Stussy tee is from a similar era, like early 2000s. This Dark Star tee, definitely some Tony Hawk Pro Skater vibes, so sick. And with some more Tony Hawk character selection vibes, we got this Black Label skateboard hoodie, so freaking dope. The colorway on this is insane. I posted this to my story on the Star Life and I had so many people asking me about this hoodie. Super sick piece. And then of course with skatewear slash streetwear, we got a little Thrasher tee and the Stussy velour jacket. Oh, also you guys see that Carhartt right there? Well, we do have more Carhartts. These should be posted at the time this video goes live, so do not sleep. Little 1980s denim jacket blanket line. I also got this one right here, which I think I picked these up in the last video, but I never actually ended up posting them. And then, of course, I have two black Carhartt work jackets that I will be posting to ThriftRO as well. And since we also showed off some Nike over there, we have some other Nike pieces, little white tag Nike fleece. I try to post vintage Nike checks, but I also post newer ones as well because I understand the vintage ones are a little bit more expensive. And I do that with a lot of different goods. Like, for example, Russell Athletic. I always preach to you guys. The vintage Russell Athletic hoodies are some of the best fitting hoodies. They are so freaking nice. In fact, in this video earlier, when the little homie came up and gave me those Magic the Gathering cards and I was wearing that Magic tee, when he actually gave me the cards, I was wearing the hoodie over it, which is why I was so amazed. But I took it off to show you guys the tee. That hoodie fits so freaking good. I also have a USA made Russell Athletic blank crew neck, as well as some newer Russell Athletic. These right here are silk tags, not woven tags. These are a little bit newer, but still really dope. And because they are newer, these will be posted for a steal. A little vintage 1990s USA
USA made. This looks like what I imagine a sunset would look like if I dropped LSD. And speaking of nice essentials, we got the Carhartt Essential.
A plethora of
Champion Reverse Weave. Look at this beautiful forest green premium Champion Reverse Weave. And then of course, last but not least, for the sweaters or outerwear, I believe I'm not really doing this in a precise order, but Tigger Crew Neck from the 1990s. And since we're talking about Disney, of course we have vintage Disney tee. This is 1999 Disneyland tee. This is actually cool because if you look, Old English Disneyland, inside the numbers is actually a puff print. I love the vintage tees that have this like raised puff print. Super dope little surf team. Sticking with the surf vibes, you got Betty Boop 2001, and it actually has embroidery hits on the bottom, and I believe there is one little Austin Powers flower right here on your lower left ass cheek. Ed Hardy, Dreamville, cool little skull tee. 1983 Sacramento Jazz Festival. I copped that from a recent trip to the thrift when I went down to the Bay, where, as you guys know earlier in this video, we discussed me just straight passing out. I also got this little Area 51 tee, which I never ended up posting. I kind of wanted this for myself. It's a little bit small. It's a single stitch, but I will be posting this as well as this dope little University of Mars collegiate tee. Some more single stitch tees. Like, there's so many items going to the site. I got this tee, another little Bigfoot golf tee. This is a 2000 San Francisco radio tee. I just love the colors. Ooh, these nature tees are so sick. Orca Journey with the orcas on the chesticle. I don't know if this is a band or what this is. If you guys have more information, let me know. It says Troopers, Casper, Wyoming, 1995 summer tour. As a prior veteran, you know I love the vintage military tees as well. Operation Desert Storm. Oh man, I cannot believe I was going through tees and I wasn't even done with outerwear. We got these two collegiate tees. Arizona Wildcats, this is a little bit bigger, 1997 NCAA. And like I mentioned earlier, the vintage Russell Athletic sweaters are so nice. The tees are just as nice. USA made. Pirate football, making memories one day at a time. The print on this is actually really sick. I forgot to talk about a couple of other pieces. Little hundreds football style jersey. We're not done with the streetwear. We also have this Burton hoodie. Zip up, super dope. Skull and crossbones right here, 13. And it's got this little hit on the wrist. Little reversible Nike windbreaker. This is a Nike zip up hoodie. Nike Air embroidered on the chest. Then on the back, you have the USA basketball embroidery. And then speaking of basketball, we have a Queens basketball on. Once again, another woven tag, Russell Athletic. This one is made in Mexico. There are a lot of other places that will sell vintage Russell Athletics for insane amounts of money because they are so popular, especially with the current Instagram aesthetic. I do have some other pieces. Some Christmas sweaters that I plan on posting when we get a little bit closer to the holidays. If you guys notice, when I do these videos, I try to get a bunch of different stuff. Always said this, but I like all types of clothes. Even when I was just making Supreme content, I would try to sprinkle in some information throughout those videos and let you guys know I like a lot of different stuff. I don't just like streetwear. I don't just like high-end. I don't just like vintage. I like a little bit of everything. I'm just a fan of clothing. So when I go out and I thrift, I just try to find cool stuff for everyone at every single point in life. That's why you can go to the website and you'll see actual thrift store prices. Like, you'll see $5 t-shirt, but you will also see more expensive $40 t-shirts, $60 t-shirts. And if they can't afford the more expensive Carhartt, the more expensive Russell Athletic hoodie or single stitch tee, hopefully I have some other cheaper alternatives. Even when you look at my tee collection, you have a bunch of random tees, streetwear tees, anime tees, sports tees, rap tees, band tees. I try to have a wide selection and I try to offer a wide selection. Just buy what you like, buy what resonates with you, and try different things out. It's one of the reasons why I like thrift. It's one of the reasons why I've always tried to encourage other people to get out and thrift. I genuinely feel like if you can't afford these things that you see, these hyped items, at least you can go hit a thrift store and try to find some alternative. I love having people come up to me and tell me like, yo, you got me into thrifting. The homie Julian even did that. He came up to me and was like, yo, I watched your videos and I got into thrifting. Like, that happens a lot. So if you see me out in the wild, you see me out in the trenches, feel free to come up, say what's up. I do appreciate you guys. Like I said, all these items that I showed you guys will be available for sale on Thrift Row, Thriftrow. The Instagram will be somewhere on the screen, and the website and Instagram will be linked in the description down below, along with a link to my personal social medias and of course, Plus One. Thank you guys so much for watching. Smash the like button, show some love in the comments, subscribe, turn on post notifications if you have not already. And of course, sharing is caring. Share it with a friend, show some love. Any interaction with these videos helps feed the YouTube algorithmic gods and allows me to keep making these videos. They do take a lot of time, as you guys see. So please show some love. I would greatly appreciate it. But anyways, as always, keep living the star life. I haven't said that in a while. Peace the fuck out. Honestly, it feels kind of weird doing that because lately I've just been saying, peace. Star like Chris, say shooting on Mets, guard these thoughts been ran through. Goddamn it, like back chief, keep drop. I don't like that shit. Lil Reese in the coupe, clip, do a backflip.